Hey, welcome back, Supply Chain Superstars. Martin here. And today, we're going after a super glamorous topic, resolving errors in goods issues. Okay. I know it's actually is not the most glamorous of topics, but it is truly an important one. Having a clean and healthy system that reflects timely and completed transactional postings is a big part of having a system we can trust. Accounting for our inventory properly and knowing where it is located opens the doors to better quality and ATP. Our advisor for today is going to lead us down this quest and to tidy our system is our friend Tom. Tom, tell us more about COGI errors and how we can actually use them to improve our system accuracy.
Well, as it happens, Martin, not only are we going to talk about how to resolve COGI errors as they occur, but also how to reduce the number of errors we're getting in the first place. Like all cleanup after the problem has occurred, the investigation and cleanup is easier the quicker you get to it. In this case, sooner is much better. If you have a COGI error, SAP can't find the balance of materials that was to be issued to the manufacturing order in the place that it was supposed to be looking. So we need to see if the quantity or location is incorrect and then get it pointed in the right direction. Let's get in the system and look at some examples. I'll tell you a story or two as we go. Now let's dive into SAP and take a closer look at COGI errors. We'll start by looking at the SAP menu and finding the transaction code for COGI. We start at the top in the logistics folder. We drop to production, drop down to shop floor control, drop down to confirmation, drop down to reprocessing, and there you'll find the COGI. The other simple trick for finding COGI is just go into your menu, type in COGI, off you go into the transaction. As we enter the COGI transaction, we can clearly see that there is a number of search criteria we can do to limit the search for specific errors, specific plants, specific situations we might be looking for. In this example, we're going to just look at plant level COGI errors and make sure we understand the status of our COGIs for the entire plant. So we're going to go into plant 1000 and execute to look for COGI errors. As we enter, we see there are two COGI errors. And it's important to remember that we want to make sure our COGIs are up to date because there's impacts on the operation in our organization when COGI errors go unchecked. We have data accuracy issues. We'll have inventory discrepancies. We will have operational inefficiencies, and we'll have a financial impact if we try to close our books at month end and COGI errors haven't been processed.